on the outskirts of Indiana.
In fact,
near Grabill, the bustling town of Grabill.
It's
farmland and school bus land. Let's head into town. We'll probably see more. Okay. Okay, so we're in Grabill now. And
to my right,
blades of grass. This is Grabill, Indiana, a bustling town of...
It's Grabill, not Grabill.
Grabill?
Grabill.
This is Grabill, Grabill, Indiana. It's pronounced Grabill. Of a general store. I guess we'll have a look inside. Maybe. So, where are we now?
We're in Grabill, Indiana.
We're in the general store.
About 10 minutes away from our house. And they have these things, honey sticks. They're good.
It's good.
They're
stuff.
Just like
snip
straws.
Them open.
Can
honey.
You attract bees with them?
Probably.
Probably.
And that's their main selling feature? Bee capture? For aviators?
For aviators?
What?
What's an aviator?
An aviator. He keeps bees in his aeroplane.
Oh, in his aeroplane.
It's a flying bee man.
Oh, okay. Well.
I read this Amish book here in the store without buying it. It says the history of the Amish goes back to Switzerland and a group of Anabaptists who followed a man named Jakob Ammann in 1693. The Roman Catholics gave the Amish a hard time, so they, like the Pilgrims, went off like a flyer to the New World, America, settling in Pennsylvania, New York, and Indiana and other states. For example, when power lines grew up, Amish leaders agreed that connecting to them wouldn't be a good idea. Not because electricity was evil, but because of that desire to remain separate and without distractions of modernism. You see, Amish people tend not to frequent the modern art wing of museums. In fact, they never. The Amish lived happily ever after until September the 11th, 1921, when a hijacked trolley car plowed into the World Trade Market on Radio Row, located on the Lower West Side in New York City. President Warren G. Harding was informed of the attack, but continued reciting "I'm a Little Teapot" to school children. In the aftermath of the disaster, it was discovered the hijacker was a rogue, radical Amish man who had broken church rules and had been excommunicated and shunned by the Amish community. They had washed their hands of him because he was obviously a nut. Anyone who ploughs a trolley into a building is a nut. Prove me wrong. Nevertheless, an unfounded mistrust for the Amish way of life began to bubble, despite the fact that their religion was based on peace. Idiot media commentators boosted their ratings by inciting hatred at every chance and at every one they could.
You know, it took me about a year to start hating the 9/11 victims' families. It took me about a year.
When an Amish church was being constructed a few blocks away from the World Trade Market ruins, they hit the wireless airwaves, even though a church is a peaceful building. And the Amish community had nothing to do with hijacking a trolley car. And on the 9th anniversary of September the 11th, Florida pastor Terry Jones decided to create a Burn an Amish Bible Day.
Now you listen here, he's not the Messiah!
Not that Terry Jones. That Terry Jones is a genius compared to this Terry Jones.
September the 11th is a day that for us as Americans will never be forgotten. It is a day that believers attacked our country. This book is not a book of peace. This book is responsible for 9/11. Come and join us, Dove World Outreach Center in Gainesville, Florida.
But thankfully, Americans weren't idiots, and there was also common sense on the wireless waves, such as the youthful Turkish radio station.
The Dove World Outreach Center. Doesn't it sound lovely and very peaceful, Dove Outreach? Well, a guy by the name of Terry Jones, he's got a brilliant idea. He wants to make the 9th anniversary of 9/11 into worldwide burning day. And I love how he says, we're telling them to stop the brutality. That's why we're going to burn their book down. Terry Jones and his wife Sylvia, they got a good little thing going. They get all these people who follow them, they indoctrinate them, and then they put them to work, okay, as any good cult would do. Do some Kingdom of God work, okay? And then they sell it on eBay and they pocket. Of course! And those people, they tell them, oh, sell your possessions, give them to me. They do, and then the workers do the selling, the packing, the shipping of the furniture, and they're all totally unpaid. But now the county that they live in figured out, hey, you know what? I'm not sure these guys are paying their taxes quite right. And the property appraiser office comes and knocks on their door. All of a sudden, the headquarters of the church were suddenly and inexplicably, as this article points out, put on the market. Shocking, it turns out that that guy would turn out to be a scam artist who, of you know, all people, would scam his own followers.
Thanks to the Youthful Turkish program, everyone saw through Terry Jones as a publicity whore. No one burnt any Bibles of any religion, because why would you do that? Peace followed, and everyone took a leaf out of the Amish book and turned off their radios. For a time being, at least. And this dark threat never reared its head again in America.
What is it they say about religion and politics? I can't remember.
These are the train tracks of Grabill. I mean, Grabill. Grabill train tracks. They're not much to look at, and the trains don't come along here often, but when they do, it's very exciting. So,
come ride that little train that is rolling down the tracks to the junction. Ready, go, junction!
Bye.
We'll see what happens.
My first.
So what is Vera Bradley and why are we here?
Vera Bradley is a company that started with two ladies in Fort Wayne, Indiana. And you see these bags everywhere. I saw some in Europe. But they started designing the patterns and sewing them themselves in their garage. And then they got bigger over like the past 25 years. And now they're ginormous. And look at all these bags. Beautiful, beautiful bags.
I take it you like them.
I love them. I love them. I just got this one. This is my new baby. It's called the mailbag, the style, because it lifts up.
Ah, yes, it reminds me of a mailman.
Mm-hmm. And the pattern is called Green Cupcakes. And every year in Fort Wayne, they have a sale at the Coliseum, and everything's like 75% off. So this bag originally is $68. I got it for $25.
Bargain, wow. Yes. Well done.
Yes, and you have to fight for patterns, because like, this pattern is brand new, and it's bright and colorful, and it's just really cheery, and everybody loved it. So we went there on the third day of the sale, and there was only about five of these bags in the whole place. So everybody's like dive bombing. I had to chase a cart for this and get this out of the pile. So
nice.
There you go. That's the story of Vera Bradley. And these are nice. Amy just got one of these because it's a wallet, but it's also a purse. All these little credit card holes.
Amazing. It's amazing how they use science in fashion.
I know. You can fit so much in these bags and it's all organized and beautiful. Vera Bradley's known for their organizing on the inside of their bags. So you can see...
Oh, yes.
You can see that all... They'll have pockets for credit cards and things. And they all have a zipper on the inside. You know, you put more in there. And this one is really cool because it's a new style. It's called the Alice bag. It's got a clutch and a pocket on the outside that you can put your cell phone and keys. So that's that bag.
And this is more exciting than the blades of grass from earlier?
Heck yes. This is, you think Fort Wayne, you think cornfields and Vera Bradley.
And blades of grass.
After the handbag purse store, I was in need of some masculinity, so I took Jessica to go look at some buffalo.
That's how they started. A horse met a cow.
I don't know what I think about that. A little too much information.
Imagination.